Navy in London. Allow me to first apologize for this interruption. I do, like many of you, appreciate the comforts of the everyday routine, the security of the familiar, the tranquility of repetition. I enjoy them as much as any bloke. But in the spirit of commemoration, whereby whose important events of the past usually associated with someone's death or at the end of some awful bloody struggle are celebrated with a nice holiday, I thought we could mark this November the 5th, a day that is sadly no longer remembered, by taking some time out of our daily lives to sit down and have a little chat.
I don't want a corporation to own my government. I don't want a corporation to take a good man that gave hope to America and turn him into a George Bush clone. That's the reason I'm here.
Thanks. And your name is?
Oh, my name's Bev.
Cool.
Hey.
You want to say anything? Look at all the signs you've got, man.
Yeah, well, no, I just picked up what was left.
Yeah. What's your first name here?
Michael.
Michael. Single pair is very important. As much as I like Obama, he kind of caved on that one.
He caved on all of them.
I know.
We're the only ones that are going to make it work.
I know. Yeah, don't worry.
Good for you, Michael. Good for you.
So you want to say anything about this movement?
Yes, it's a spiritual movement worldwide. It ain't going to stop at Pine Mountain Club if we keep showing up.
Amen.
Where it's at.
Yeah.
It started a long time ago.
It did.
Just like us.
Started with the American Revolution. You want to say anything?
Sure, yeah. I'm here for every protester in the world. I'm here supporting every homeless mum, every homeless child that is not cared for in America.
Right on.
And we are going to change this world to make it a better place.
Right on. And your first name?
Graham.
Thanks, Graham. Do you want to say anything? Let me look at your signs first. U.S. government, the best money can buy. Okay. Anything else?
Well, the reason I'm here is because the corporations only value profit but not people, and they're systematically eliminating the middle class, and I want to take back our democracy.
Thank you. And your first name?
Leslie.
Thanks, Leslie. Okay. Mar, you want to say anything? Are you shy? You're kind of shy? Let me at least get your sign. Mar's my neighbor. But she has to look at this face every day I walk by. Walking the dogs. Middle class. Thanks.
Sick I'm one fat. Of those.
Hi.
Hi, Catherine.
Hi, Peter.
I know you've got a few things to say about this movement. This
yeah.
worldwide, it's actually a worldwide movement.
It's a worldwide movement, and it's not at all amorphous, as some people have charged. It's a movement to make government operate on behalf of the people. Democracy is power to the people, not power to the corporations. And right now, the corporations are ruling our country by their campaign contributions and just by the way they lobby and twist things. And I have a particular goal in mind as an educator. I see my students, I see some of them having to try to graduate early because their parents have run out of money so they can't stay at UCLA for the extra quarter they had planned to. In other words, they want to graduate, you know, rather than in June, they have to graduate in March, which means that they are taking an overload of courses and they're also working maybe 20, 30 hours a week. And they're going under. Their education is suffering. UCLA has homeless students. UCLA now has a food bank.
Isn't that something? Yeah.
You know, as
homeless
an educator,
students.
It's unbelievable. Really sad
yeah.
that now education is going to be only for the wealthy.
Yeah.
And the other thing that bothers me about they say we can raise tuition because we'll increase student aid to the needy. Well, student aid usually consists of loans at exorbitant rates. Now, when I was in school, student loans were basically, there was no interest while you were in school, and then when you were out, it was like 1% to 3%, depending on how long you took to pay it off.
Uh-huh.
And now it's 6%, 8%. It's huge. And so these students come out with these enormous debts that they can never, never, never pay off. I know some now, some parents whose kids are going to school now, whose parents graduated like in the middle of the 80s or maybe 90s, and now the parents are still paying off their student debts, and now their 17-year-olds are expected to take on more student debt. It's just not fair. The banks have gotten it their own way. They haven't been regulated for years, and it's time they were regulated. It's time that Banking Regulation Commission, the Credit Card Commission, was put in full operation. And
corporations are part of the problem, too,
and
not just the banks, right?
Not just the banks.
Right.
The banks are just one example
they
of
get
a big
all the tax
corporation.
Breaks.
Banks are corporations.
Treat.
And you have the Wall Street corporations, but it's any really big corporation. When they
big one.
And we are talking about big corporations,
yeah.
Not the small business. We like small business.
And we're not even, this isn't a protest against rich people. It's just it's the abuse of power and the abuse of some of the very top wealthy that
exactly. We just want them to pay their fair share.
Right.
You know, paying a percent of your income when you're making $20,000 a year is hard. But when you're making $1 million a year, to pay twice as much percentage or three times as much percentage, it's not so hard. You can do without an extra yacht. So, no, great. Get rich. Have fun. But pay your fair share towards the democracy.
Right,
do you want to walk out of your rich mansion and see beggars in the street? Do you want to have sick people dying in our emergency rooms because they can't afford to go to doctors?
Healthcare.
Do we really? Yeah, we need a single-payer healthcare.
We need single-payer.
You know, and I don't know what these rich people are thinking about, because
we could start with a public option, but it should eventually evolve into a single payer.
Single payer. Has to be single payer, I think.
Fewer bombs and more saving lives.
Yes, bring the money back from the military and put it into health care, put it into education.
Yeah, we need a defense, but the military budget's insane.
It's totally insane, but you know what the strongest defense is?
Yeah.
It's a prosperous,
happy,
healthy population.
Right.
Because then everybody is willing to go to the defense of their country.
Yeah, you're more patriotic when your government's pitching in too.
That's right. People are not going to be rebelling in the streets if they're well fed and they, you know, and they're happy.
Look at Canada.
If they feel their government is working for them, then they'll want to defend that government.
Yeah. Look at the crime. Look at, like, for instance, the crime rate in Canada. It's because those people are less full of less angst.
Yeah.
Because if they get sick, they can see a doctor.
That's right. And the crime rate is now beginning to go up in the United States.
Like crazy.
Because of this.
Even locally. All these break-ins.
Even locally. We get a lot of break-ins. We've never had a break-in in the post office before. Now we get that. The jewelry store to get the precious metal. People are hurting. And I don't condone any kind of lawlessness. One can understand why it's increasing when people are in desperate need.
Right.
And they feel hopeless. People can be poor, but if they have hope, then they'll keep working within the system. If they have no hope.
Right on.
Then this country's in trouble.
Great. Anything you want to wrap it up with, or is that it? Or
I think that's about it.
Thanks, Catherine. And you're a professor at
UCLA.
UCLA. Thanks so much.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Resident of Pine Mountain Club.
We are the 99.5%. Puppets, we fill up that extra 0.5%. I'm here because my separated Republican husband, Ted, refused to join me. He's not helping matters much. We're getting the honks today, and we're getting a little foul language, too. A woman just drove by and said we should go and join the people in L.A. with all the urine and feces. Well, she should just wake up. Boy, was she a... No, I won't even stoop to her level. We are the 99.5%.
I think you guys are kind of dumb.
Who are you?
I'm a elephant Republican.
Does that make you a Republican?
Very funny. Very, very funny. You occupiers have such a wit about you. So why are you doing this? You should go to L.A. and join the feces and the poop down there. You know? because that's all you're full of.
You don't know what you're talking about. For the last couple decades, it's been all for trickle-down. It's not gotten us anywhere but for the mega-rich.
Well, what's wrong with that?
You are dumb, aren't you? It hasn't worked. Somehow the middle class is getting smaller and smaller, and it's just the super poor and the super rich these days. Why the upper 1% can't be taxed? Matt Damon! Matt Damon says, tax me! We are Matt Damon! Tax Matt Damon!
Well, yeah, I agree with that.
Tax Matt Damon! We are the 99.5%.
Let me have one of those. I like that tax Matt Damon part.
Okay.
Tax.
Tax Matt Damon. And George Clooney, for that matter.
Tax Matt Damon. He welcomes it.
He sure does. He's a patriot.
All right. You're convincing me.
I got a lot of this from Rachel Maddow.
She's hot.
Yeah, but you don't have a chance. She's gay.
Well, she's still hot. We are the 99%.
Thank you.